from Peterborough Virtual GBRF to Gangster Royal Mail Terminal.
Oh, yeah.
And we've got...
Probably will, to be fair. Type Palmy Lane in. Yeah, it's all brand new, mate. Well, definitely. It's going to go up again, though. No, it's not. It's staying down. Here it is, look. I can see it already. Oh, I thought you meant the signals. Because that's what he was like last time. He was like, the signals are both green. Yeah, especially when it's about when it hits a bump in the track and it just all just suddenly just makes that noise.
Just see Barnby Lane.
Went back down, went up.
No, went up.
It's cool, isn't it?
Time.
So busy, isn't it? Yeah, from this angle anyway. You've got such a good
side.
You what?
Go from the other side.
Oh, you can get, you've got a good view, but it's just all those gantry posts are in the way, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, they do bloody go down quite late, don't they? Considering the fact that well, even though it's quite a while away from where the trains are coming from, it just looks like they're really close, doesn't it? Look at the view, look. Just see the train coming like on the video, and then from that direction, don't know if I can get it properly, that's how far you can see that way as well. Yeah. You see Claypole as well, look,
yeah,
on the camera.
Yeah,
I've got such good memory of coming around these crossings because when we used to work at the shop, we used to every Tuesday when I was about 10 years old, we used to go to Chatsworth delivering pies all the way to Chatsworth, and we used to go over this crossing.
Yeah,
yeah. Derbyshire, in this Chesterfield area, yeah, Chatsworth Farm Shop. Yeah. And we used to deliver pies every Tuesday, like, as long as I wasn't at school. Like, in the holidays, me and this bloke used to go to Chatsworth Farm Shop, come over this crossing every day, every Tuesday, because there was the butchers in the village as well, in Claypole, we used to deliver to. So every Tuesday we used to come over this crossing, and then I used to catch most Tuesdays, and then I could just see this crossing from Claypole as well. That's how I know this crossing so well. Good times they were.
Actually, do you know what? You can just see Broadfin from here.
You can do, probably, because it the reason why you wouldn't have been able to is because that would have gone down before this one would have.
Yeah.
So you wouldn't have seen it. If you look, you might... Yeah, the barriers are up. I can just see the barrier. Look, right there, look. Between the signals. So big.
Is that geezer in the box still controlling?
Yeah. Just this. I think it's just this, Oster and Bullpit and Barmby and Barmby Road and Bullpit he controls from here.
So
this crossing.
The five down to.
Yeah, just five crossings he controls, I think, anyway. I'm not quite sure.
Six?
What? Yeah, six. And then Carton on Trent, they control the crossings between South Muscombe and Egmanton, I think. Yeah. And then I think after that it's the crossings, the rest of them are controlled between
still not one at Grove Road?
Yeah, there's one. I don't know about Grove Road. I think that might be controlled from Doncaster. I'm not sure. But then Peterborough, I think Helpston controls them big crossings, Tallington and Lowland and Maxine and all that lot. So I think it's like it's different sections of the line that are controlled from these sort of boxes. I'm not quite sure.
your key basket.
Oh, fucking hell, mate. So that means that's it, I'm leaving my car in now then.
Hey?
That's it, I'm leaving my car in now then.
No, that
you
that.
Speed,
I told you that wasn't the trend that you saw a minute ago. Like, it's literally because I don't know if there's a hill or something before the.
It was.
No, doesn't take long, does it?
No.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. Hang on. I thought it was running on diesel then.
I did for that.